Hey guys, what's going on? James here, and in this video today, we're going to be previewing the Tampa Bay Buccaneers wildcard round matchup versus the Philadelphia Eagles. If you guys are new here, go ahead and subscribe, hit the like button if you do enjoy these types of videos, and leave your thoughts, opinions, and your score predictions for this Buccaneers wildcard round matchup down in the comment section below. I would love to hear your guys' thoughts, opinions, and your score predictions. So, folks, I have a lot of thoughts about this game, right? And the first thought that came to my mind was, this is clutch time, right? This is, you know, the highest of high pressure situations. If you lose, you're done. That means that you are out. Your season is over. You know, Super Bowl defense, done for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers if they lose. So, I'm a little nervous, right? I know people are going to say, well, come on, it's the Philadelphia Eagles. But, you know, hey, you cannot take any team lightly in the playoffs. I think that every team in the NFC and the AFC are all, you know, worthy, very formidable teams. You know, the Eagles being no exception. The Buccaneers should not take the Eagles lightly, nor do I think that they will. But yeah, definitely a high-pressure situation, not just for the team, but obviously for fans as well. It's okay to be nervous, right? But at the end of the day, you know, these guys obviously were in those situations last year, and they made it all the way to the Super Bowl. They won the Super Bowl. These guys perform well in clutch situations. Tom Brady, right, performs well in clutch situations. So while I have my own nervousness and worry as a fan, you can bet that the team is going to be ready. They're going to go out there and they are going to give it their all, you know. But that was the first thought, was the realization of, oh man, if the Buccaneers lose, their season's done. That's a big deal. The next thought that I had in my mind was, you know, thinking about the Eagles rushing attack versus the Tampa Bay Buccaneers rushing defense, right? The Eagles right now, as it stands, they have the best rushing attack in the entire NFL. Jalen Hurts, I think he's a fantastic quarterback. I think he will be a great quarterback in this league for many years. Him, some of the other Eagles running backs that are in that group, they have done some very, very good work. And it really all kind of started versus Tampa Bay all the way back in week number 6, right? They had 100 rushing yards in that game. That was whenever we first saw cracks forming in what was the impenetrable armor of the Buccaneers' rushing defense. And since then, the Buccaneers have given up some good amounts of rushing yards in certain games. But, you know, they have also shown that they can still stop the run when they absolutely want to. It's going to be a windy game out there, which is going to obviously cater to the run. It's going to cater to the Eagles' game plan, right? So it's going to be an even bigger responsibility for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers rushing defense to regain some of their form, right? Their best in league rushing defense. They're going to have to, you know, really generate some of that ability here in this game, because I think it's going to be crucial in terms of stopping the Eagles' rushing attack. Kind of like what happened with the Indianapolis Colts game, right? Stopping Jonathan Taylor was so huge in regards to stopping the Colts' offense as a whole. I think 100% the same thing could be said here versus the Philadelphia Eagles in this wild card matchup. The next thought I had in my mind, guys, was I was thinking about some X factors on the offensive side of the football, right? And two guys that came to mind were Tom Brady, of course, right? He's the GOAT, and Rob Gronkowski. And, you know, just talking about Tom Brady first, he's the GOAT, right? I talked about guys who are ready for high-pressure situations. Tom Brady's lived that basically every single year of his career, you know, in the NFL, right? The guy lives, thrives for high-pressure situations. This game's going to be no different. It's going to be, you know, very cool to just see the GOAT just do GOAT things, right? This is where he is at his best, is in playoff games. So, you know, let's watch him work. Let's see him continue to do incredibly amazing things, even at the age that he is at. He keeps on defying the odds, and now he's finally really getting into his element in playoff football. you know, hopefully it'll be continuing just the great things that we have already seen. In the case of Rob Gronkowski, I think Rob Gronkowski is going to be a humongous piece to what the Tampa Bay Buccaneers do here on the offensive side of the football. He was not there in the Buccaneers' last matchup versus the Philadelphia Eagles. He was still recovering from that rib injury he had suffered. So I think it's going to be huge. As I said, it's going to be a windy game out there, so it's going to probably be a good amount of passes that are kind of checked down, safety blanket types of passes. Enter Rob Gronkowski, man. He has been fantastic this year when he is healthy. If he was healthy the whole year, there's no doubt in my mind he would have had 1,000 yards receiving. Heck, he probably would have been one of the top receivers, period, in the entire league this year. So, you know, I think that Tom Brady and the Buccaneers offense are going to lean on Gronkowski a lot in this game. Same with guys like Mike Evans, Rashad Perriman, and Tyler Johnson as well, but I really do think that Gronkowski is going to be the X factor for this Buccaneers offense. Bold prediction, I'm going to say he's going to get over 100 receiving yards in this game. And unfortunately, Leonard Fournette, I did have him as a really big piece of this offense as well in this game. He's out. The running backs for this game are going to be Keyshawn Vaughn, Le'Veon Bell, and a returning Giovanni Bernard, which is a huge, huge blow to this Buccaneers offense to not have Leonard Fournette out there. But I'm going to say now that, you know, Le'Veon Bell and Giovanni Bernard, those two guys are going to be the running backs to step up in this game. I think that they are going to get a lot of check down types of passes and definitely get a lot of, you know, opportunities thrown their way in this game just because I think the flow of the game plan and the weather conditions as well. So, yeah, definitely pay attention to Rob Gronkowski. Definitely pay attention to Giovanni Bernard and Le'Veon Bell as well. Then folks, that's pretty much it for most of my thoughts in this game. Last thing I guess I could say here is fundamentals, man. You can't afford to make simple mistakes. We've not seen it too much from the Tampa Bay Buccaneers this year, but, you know, drive extending penalties, drive killing penalties. These are the things that cannot happen. These are the things that can decide whether or not you go home. You are eliminated from the playoffs. You don't get a second chance or advancing to the next round. Same thing with, you know, other basic fundamentals like tackling. That's going to be huge. The Bucs need to be disciplined, and they need to have all their fundamentals in a row. We've seen this team not have the best tackling in games past this year in certain games. That cannot happen. You know, you look at guys like Devin White, Lavonte David, the outside linebackers, the secondary, you know, this, especially this defense, you know, they've got to tackle well. You know, they really do, and they got to make sure on both sides of the football that they're not getting, you know, just very crazy, frustrating penalties that can kill drives for their offense or extend drives for opposing offenses. Because again, that could be the deciding factor as to whether or not you're going home. So the fundamentals are going to be key here. Make your, you know, field goals and your extra points as well. That's also going to be huge. But folks, that's it. That's kind of all my thoughts I've got here on this game. I do still have the Tampa Bay Buccaneers winning this game. I think it's going to be really a drag out kind of brawl. It's going to be a windy day. I expect the Buccaneers offense to probably not take as many deep shots as they usually do. And I expect the Eagles to try and incorporate their rushing attack, you know, as heavily as they can. So I think it's going to be a close drag out kind of brawl. I have the Tampa Bay Buccaneers winning 21-17. But what do you guys think? Let me know your thoughts about this down in the comment section below. I'd love to hear your guys' thoughts and opinions. Thank you so much for watching this video. Hope y'all enjoyed, and I will see you all in the next video or the next live stream. But until then, and as always, guys, goodbye for now, and go Bucs.